What's up, you guys, man? I'm in a 2020 Ford Expedition Platinum. I'm talking about the top of the top line. Starting out in a back third row seat. And I know that's real big if you have a family. And I gotta say, I'm 5'5". I got a lot of leg room because I'm short. But I'm pretty sure if you were tall, you can just, you know, scoot these two seats up. And you will have a lot of leg room. And you will have a lot of headspace as well. And one thing I like about this is that it has a button that you press and it reclines the seat back. And you press this one, it'll come up. And you can press it to stop it, but it can go all the way up. You got two cup holders back here, USB port, speakers. You got a lot of space right here too. You can control your climate control back here, heated seats. Two USB ports, a full power outlet. You can control the media back here. Let's check. I think that's like an aftermarket that you can get, like how the Mercedes is. You can get it after. Also, what's this? Speaker and a speaker. Let's see what the door handle look like. I mean, the trunk. The trunk space. It's all right. It's not as much. Yeah, it's like the Yukon, but I mean, one thing I like about this one, I mean, the seats recline back. That's dope. Or the other one. So a power let down. I see if it power go, I mean if it power back up. It does. Come on now, Yukon don't do that. And you got trunk space underneath the, I can't even lift this thing up. There we go. Got some storage. Cargo net. I wanna say like your flat tire stuff is up in here. LED light. But. And they got the heavy duty tow package on this. So I guess it comes with like heavy duty components as far as like suspension and things like that. 22 inch rims, power running boards, a double moon roof. You got your heated and cool seats. I turn this one off. There we go. So heated and cool seats. It got your parallel parking, so we can parallel park for you and park regular for you as well. 4x4 modes, wood grain trimming, You got your wireless charging port. Or a charging pad, sorry. Trailer backup assist. Hill descent. So when you towing or going down the hill, you can press that. Traction control off and on. Hazard, lane departure warning, auto stop start, 360 view camera. Then you can change the modes, front. And it got massaging seats, something the Yukon don't got. Okay, let's see, what does that say? Oh, there. You feel yours? So we got adaptive cruise control, which is like you set a speed or it'll keep a distance from the car in front of you and it'll maintain it. So if it's a car that's close up on you, it'll slow down the vehicle. Then once the car speed up in front of you, the it'll resume its the amount or speed that you set it for. So that's a cool option when you're traveling. All your controls over here with the light function. You can dim the instrument cluster, your fog lights. It do got ambient lighting. Memory seating. I don't know what that is. Power folding mirrors. Blind spot monitoring. Yeah, it's fully loaded, man. It's a Platinum. What do you think of it?
How much is this truck?
What?
How much is this truck?
So, this 2024 Expedition Platinum costs $81,540. And here go all the options.
19 miles per gallon. That's not bad for a
big old
truck.
And a horsepower, 480 foot of torque. So that's pretty fast for a full size truck. That's a 3.5 EcoBoost. The same engine in my truck.
So it's a V6.
It's a V6. And they got incentives on us. The Yukon.
Yeah.
I mean, the Yukon nice. It's nice.
No, I'm saying do your comparison.
I ain't got time all the time to be doing all that. And I'm pretty sure he probably busy. Come on now, for this big old truck, don't it get up? Heavy as heck.
This is bigger than that.
But this is an aluminum body frame. So way less.
Yeah, so when you crash and then what?
No, it's actually strong. The way they engineered. So I came to Jewel just to see how this parking feature worked. We gonna see how it works. Why is it not picking up? It's perpendicular. Ah, it's all reverse.
Your foot ain't on nothing.
Yeah, it is.
Why?
I gotta control the gas. It's gonna control the steering wheel. Shift for it. So with this one, you gotta control the gas and then you gotta control the shifts. The computer controls the steering wheel. Ta-da!
It should just do it
for you. The other one do it. You comparing a Mercedes to a Ford American car.
Well, do the other one.
Do what? The front?
Whatever that parking was.
That was just it.
What's this one?
To turn it off. I'm driving this thing like it's mine. I love the way it drives. Don't you? I mean, for what it is.
You're used to a big old truck. You got a big old truck now. So it probably feels the same way as your truck do.
Comparing, I never seen the 2021 Escalade in person, but I seen it online. But comparing that with this and a Yukon Denali, I said like the Escalade got, I love the instrument cluster in a infotainment center. But after being in the Yukon and this, far as like the stitching goes and the interior go, I say Ford got those two beat. Now I haven't, like I said, I haven't been in the Escalade. I have to go in person and go check one out and look at the interior though. But comparing the Yukon and the Ford, I give it to the Ford far as the interior go. That was an older model. 2019, was it?
I thought that was
new. Nah. The 2021's out.